Hello students, in this video we are going to learn about empirical relation between mean, mode and median. So this empirical relation is mode is equal to mean median minus 2 mean. So if among three quantities, if two quantities are given, then we can find third quantity. So we will take one example. Here mean is 60 given and median is 50. So we have to find mode. So we have to use this relation. So mode is equal to, first time writing this relation, mode is equal to 3 median minus 2 mean. So 3 into median is 50 given. 3 into 50 minus 2 into mean is given 60, 2 into 6, 3 into 50, that is 150 minus 2 into 60, this is 120. So 150 minus 120, that is a 30. So mode is equal to 30. So if two quantities are given, we can find third quantity by using this empirical relation. Okay students, one more concept is there in your worksheet, combining. So we will take directly example. There are three sections A, B and C in class 10 with 25, 40 and 35 students respectively. The average marks obtained by section A, B and C are 70%, 65% and 50% respectively. Find the average marks of entire class. So first we have to find, now here what is given, in section A 25 students are there and average marks of these students is 70%. In section B 40 students are there and average marks of that 40 students is 65%, and in section C 35 students are there and average marks of that 35 students is 50%. So how we will get sum of marks in section A, that is directly 25 into 70%, because we know that formula of mean, x bar is equal to sum of observation divided by number of observation. If we have to find sum, then x bar into this number of observations. So if you have to find sum of marks in section A, that is number of observations or number of students here, 25 multiplied by x bar, that is average marks in section A 70%. So 25 into 70, that is a sum of marks in section A. So this is 1750. Similarly, sum of marks of students in section B, that is equal to, now in section B 40 students are there and average marks of 40 students is 65. So sum of all marks of all students, that is 40 into 65, that is equal to 2600. And if we find sum of marks in section C, that is equal to 35 students are there in section C, so 35 into 50. So this answer is 1750. Now we have to find the average marks of entire class. So we have to add all these sums and divide it by number of students. So all 25 plus 40 plus 35. So if we have to find sum, average, then x bar is equal to, this we have to denote by x bar. So x bar is equal to, first sum is 1750 plus second sum is 2600 plus last is 1750, and divided by number of students are 25 plus 40 plus 30, 25 plus 40 plus 35. So this sum we will get 6100 divided by this is 100. So if we find average of entire class, that is 61%. So x bar is equal to 61%. Or this we can find directly. There is a formula. So combining formula is x bar is equal to n1 x1 bar plus n2 x2 bar plus n3 x3 bar and so on. Suppose here r number of observations are there, so nr x r bar divided by number of observations that is n1 plus n2 up to nr. This is the formula